Thank you for joining us for Love Light's virtual classes on our YouTube channel. Today is going to be a day to listen to the body, connect with your breath, and try to quiet the mind. So come to a comfortable seat. Begin by closing the eyes. Feeling the six bones ground into the earth. Extending the spine nice and tall and long. Taking a breath in and bringing the shoulders up to the ears. Exhaling, rolling the shoulders down the back. Inhale, feel the crown of the head lifting. Exhale, relaxing the muscles in the and for the next few moments, follow the breath. Exhaling out of the mouth. Again, inhale through the nose. Exhaling out of the mouth. Feel the mind beginning to settle. Making yourself present in the space. Leaving all concern outside. Bringing the hands to heart center, thumbs into the stomach. If there's an intention you'd like to set for your practice today, think of that hand, keeping it close to your heart. Taking a nice deep inhale, make the sacred sound on. Inhale. Bring your thumbs to the forehead, just bowing to seal your intention. Gently placing hands on the knees. Once again, finding the spine nice and tall and long. Just going to begin with a few rounds of square breathing. It's a calming breath done in and out through the nose. We're going to inhale for a count of four. We'll hold and retain the breath for four. Exhale for four and hold for four. I'll keep the count. Begin by inhaling. Two, three, four. Hold, two, three, four, exhale, two, three, four, hold, two, three, four, inhale, two, three, four, hold, two, three, four, Three more rounds on your own. As you return, passively breathing in and out through the nose, noticing the effects on the body, on the mind. Begin to flutter the eyes open. We're going to begin with some trunk rolls, warming up the spine. So as we inhale, pull the body forward. And as we round the body, hollow the belly out in one direction. Exhale. Following your breath, connecting to the movement. One more in this direction, the reverse direction. One more in this direction, and then finding the spine in a nice, tall, neutral position once again.
If I could let go.
Grounding the sit bones, spine is nice and tall and long, crown of the head is lifting, and shoulders are rolling down the back. Taking a breath and sweeping the arms up, gaze up and inhale. Exhale, folding the body. Allow the head and neck to relax. Connecting to your breath. Beginning to walk the hands in towards the body.
That's the right time of judgment.
Once again, sweeping the arms up, gaze up, inhale. Exhale, gentle twist to the right. Not your deepest twist, nice and easy. Sweeping the arms up, gaze up, inhale. Exhale, gentle twist to the left. Sweeping the arms up, gaze up, inhale. And exhale, folding the body forward one more time. Notice where the mind is. If it's drifted to another place, bring it back. Remaining in the present. Mm-hmm. walking the hands in towards the body. And bringing the body into tabletop. If you have any concerns with your knees, placing them lightly underneath the knees. Hands directly under the shoulders. Hips in line with the knees. We're going to continue to warm up the spine with some cat cows. So as we dip the belly, gaze up and inhale. And exhale, rounding for cat. And following your own breath to your own movement. Continuing this motion, dipping the belly, gazing up and inhale. Exhale as we round for cat. Closing the eyes. Connecting the breath with the movement. One more in each direction. And then finding the spine in a nice neutral position. Abdomen is engaged. We're going to sweep the right arm up towards the sky. Gaze up. Taking a breath in. And exhale, threading the arm through, coming down onto the shoulder and the side of the cheek. Walking that left arm out in front. And staying here, extending that left leg out towards that hand. And you can stay here, or you can bring that left arm up, reaching around the back, to the front of the thigh. Keeping the eyes closed. Beginning to come out of the pose, bringing the arm back around, and bringing the body back into tabletop. Making sure once again the hands are under the shoulders, fingers are spread nice and wide. We're going to extend that left arm up to the sky. Gaze up and inhale. And exhale, reaching the arm through and under. Coming down onto the shoulder and the side of the face. Moving that right arm out in front. And taking the variation to come the other side, maybe extending that leg out towards the hand. And then reaching that arm up and back, reaching for the thigh. Beginning to unfold the body, bringing the arm back around, and coming back into tabletop. We're going to walk the hands 68 inches out in front, and do some nice wide hip rolls. So drop the hips down to the earth, And in one direction, bringing the hips around. Connecting the breath with the movement. So as we come forward with the hand, and exhale to round. And one more in this direction, and then the reverse direction. And one more in this direction, and then bringing the body all the way back into child's pose. Allow the body to relax. Then we're going to come into our first down dog. So curling the toes under. Reaching the hips up and back. Finding some movement here, pedaling the feet, bending the knees. Try to tune into what the body is asking for today. Relax the head and the neck. Rolling the shoulders away from the body. Finding stillness. Forehead is reaching down to the earth. Beginning to walk the feet up towards the hands for a first forward fold, uttanasana. Allow the body to hang heavy, bringing the belly to the thighs. Maybe reaching for opposite elbows and swaying the body from side to side. Finding stillness and allowing the arms to come down to the earth. One vertebrae at a time, slowly rolling up. Allowing the head to come up last. Coming into Tadasana Mountain Pose. So closing the eyes here. Feeling all four corners of the feet grounded into the earth. Calf muscles are engaged, thigh muscles are engaged, the knees are not up. Pelvis is slightly tucked under, abdomen is in. Shoulders are rolling down the back, chest is open. Crown of the head is lifted. Feeling the strength in this pose. Mountain moves while they're all swings. Remembering the intention that you set for your practice today. Taking it close to your heart at all times. You're going to reach up, gaze up, and inhale. Exhale, fold the body forward. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, stepping back to plank. Staying here for a moment, breathing in, exhale, drop down to the knees and back to child's pose. Keeping the nose and the forehead close to the floor, pulling through for Bhujangasana, cobra pose, inhale. Exhaling into down dog. Once again, feeling that tailbone reaching up, shoulders rolling away from the body, relaxing the head and the neck. connecting with the breath. Stepping, walking, or hopping the feet forward. And exhale, fold. Inhale, reach up the inside. Exhale, Tadasana, the mountain pose. Inhale, reach up the inside. Exhale, fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, stepping back to plank. Taking a breath in. Exhale, dropping down to the knees and back to child's pose. Keeping the nose and forehead close to the earth, pulling through for Bhujangasana Cobra pose. Inhale. And exhale to down dog. Stepping, walking, or hopping the feet forward. Exhale, fold. Inhale, reach up, gaze up. Exhale, Tadasana. Inhale, reach up, gaze up. Exhale, fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, stepping back to plank. This time, bringing the body down, knees, chest, chin. Exhale. Inhale for cobra. Exhale to down dog. Connect with your breath. Stepping, walking, or hopping the feet forward. Exhale, fold. Inhale, reach up, gaze up. Exhale, Tadasana. Inhale, reach up, gaze up. Exhale, fold. Inhale, halfway up. Exhale, stepping back to plank. Dropping the body down, knees, chest, chin, or Chaturanga. Pulling through for cobra or up dog. And exhaling into down dog. Connecting with the breath. Extending the left leg long behind. Really reaching that leg up. Opening up the hip, allow that belly to drop over, stacking the hips. Extending that leg long again. And coming into lizard on the left. Bringing that left foot forward. Really gluing that shoulder and knee and finding some movement here, rocking the body back and forth. And when you're ready, dropping that back knee, uncurling your toes, staying up on the hands, maybe dropping down onto the right elbow first, maybe the left. Allow the body to settle in. Close the eyes and connect with the breath.
Thank you.
onto the hands, curling the back toe under, and bringing that left leg back into plank. Take a breath in, and exhale with your knees, chest, chin, and Chaturanga. Pulling through for Cobra or Up Dog, and then into Down Dog. Extending that right leg nice and long, really reaching up, and then staggering that right hip over the left, opening up. Notice where the mind is. Extending that leg long again. And coming into Uttana Prasthasana on the right. Making sure once again that shoulder and knee are glued together and finding some movement on the back and forth. When you're ready, dropping that back knee and uncurling toes. Staying up on the hands or maybe dropping down onto the left elbow and then the right. And if you can easily come down onto the elbows, extending the arms out, bringing the chest down towards the earth. Always breathing. Sending that right leg back into plank. Taking a breath in here. And exhale, leave your knees, chest, chin, or Chaturanga. Pulling through for Cobra or Up Dog. And exhale into Down Dog. Making sure the fingers are spread nice and wide. Tailbone is really reaching up. Shoulders are rolling away from the back. Relaxing the head and the neck. Bringing the body into plank. Bringing the feet to touch. Coming into Vinyasa on the right, side plank on the right. So turning the body. Reaching that arm up. Always drop the knee underneath the hip. Closing the eyes here. Coming back into plank. Once again, having feet touch, and Vinyasa on the left, side plank on the left. Lifting the hips up, really reaching out through that top hand. That right leg long behind, and stepping forward for warrior one. When we're in warrior one, back foot is on a 45 degree angle. Front knee is stacked over the ankle, not cast. Hips are squared forward. Relax the shoulders down the back. Feeling the energy coming up through the fingertips. Taking a breath in. And exhaling into warrior two. Making sure that front knee is not caving in, but pushing out towards the pinky edge of the foot. Gazing out over the front fingers, feeling an energy from fingertips to fingertips. And dropping that right arm down onto the knee. Coming into side angle. Then reaching the arm up or over the head. Finding where you are comfortable today. And if you can, drop the hand down to the earth, inside the foot, keeping the chest open. Slowly rising back up to warrior two. Turning those front toes towards the side of the mat. Bringing the hands to the lower back, fingertips pointed up if you can. Going to put a slight bend in the knees and begin to push the hips forward, opening up the chest, dropping the head back. Take a breath and rise up. And exhale, folding the body forward. Reaching for either the outside of the feet or taking our peace fingers around our big toes. Tailbone is up, elbows are up, and the crown of the head is down towards the earth. Bringing the fingertips out in front with a nice flat back. Bringing the hands to the hips and slowly rising with a nice flat back. Taking those right toes and pointing toward the top of the mat. Coming into a high lunge, you're going to spin onto that left foot. Taking a breath in and twisting to the right. Bringing that elbow to the outside of the knee. Gazing up and back. Trying to work the palms towards the center of the chest. And if having the leg extended is too much, dropping down to the knee. Slowly rising back to a high plunge. Bringing the hands down to the earth. Framing the foot, stepping the right foot back into plank. Taking a breath in. And exhaling, knees, chest, chin, or chaturanga. Through to cobra, up dog, breathing in. And exhaling into down dog. Extending that left leg long behind and stepping through for warrior one. Once again, making sure that back foot is on a 45 degree angle. Front knee is over the ankle, not past. Hips are squared forward. Shoulders are relaxing down the back. Feeling an energy coming through the fingers. Taking a breath in. And exhaling into warrior two. Once again, checking at that front knees, pushing out towards the pinky edge of the foot, gazing over the front fingertips, feeling the energy and the strength, fingertips to fingertips. Slowly rising back into warrior two. And then taking those front toes out towards the edge of the mat. Once again, hands to the lower portion of the back, fingertips pointed up if you can. Slight bend in the knees and begin to push the hips forward, opening up the chest, allowing the head to drop back. Always breathing. Breath in, rise up, and exhale, folding the body forward. Reaching for the outer part of our feet, grabbing our big toes with our peace fingers. Tailbone is up, elbows are up, crown of the head is coming down. Bringing the hands out in front for a nice flat back. And then bringing the hands to the waist and slowly rising. Taking the left toes and pointing them towards the top of the mat and coming into a high lunge. So gaining your stability here. Take a breath in. And exhale, twisting to the left, bringing that elbow to the outside of the knee, working the palms towards the center of the chest. And once again, if this is too much, you can drop that back knee. Taking a breath in and exhaling, knees, chest, chin, Chaturanga. Root of cobra, up dog, breathing in. And exhaling into down dog. Connect with your breath. sending that right leg nice and long behind. Really reaching up. And coming into pigeon on the right. So bring that knee behind the right wrist. And before you fold forward, making sure the left leg is extended nice and long behind. Walking the fingertips back, making any adjustments that are needed. Take a breath in and exhale, folding the body. Allow yourself to settle in. Remembering your intention. Those back toes under and sending that right leg up and back once again, making any movements that the body needs, and then finding yourself in down dog. Extending that left leg nice and long behind, really reaching up and coming into pigeon palm. Bring that knee behind the wrist. And before you fold forward, checking that the back leg is nice and straight and long. Walking the fingertips back. Making any adjustments that you need. Taking a breath in. And exhale, folding the body forward. Beginning to walk the hands back in towards the body. Curling those back toes under. Reaching the left leg up and back. Making any movements the body needs. And then finding yourself in down dog. Begin to walk the feet up towards the hands. Taking the hands underneath the feet. Making the toes reach up towards the wrist. Begin to pull the body in towards the thighs. Elbows are coming out. Taking the hands out from underneath the feet. Coming into standing split, lifting the left leg up and behind. Bring the body down towards the leg. And if you want to work on balance, taking one hand around the ankle or maybe both. And slowly drawing that leg back down towards the earth. And then begin by extending the right leg behind. Standing split. Reaching that leg up, bringing the body down towards the thigh. And once again, if you want to work on balance, try to reach for the ankle. Maybe one hand, maybe both. And then slowly bringing that leg down. Moving the feet out towards the edges of the mat. Slowly rolling the body up. And coming into squatting pose. So allow the body to sink down. Spine is nice and tall. Crown of the head is lifting up. Elbows are pushing out on the knees. Engaging Mula Bandha. And then slowly rolling all the way down onto the back. Coming into waterfall or Sardanasana shoulder stand. So in waterfall, our legs are going to be straight, feet are flexed. Coming into shoulder stand, the toes are pointed, lifting the body all the way up, supporting the lower back with the hands. Trying to bring the chest towards the chin. Always keeping the head stable, not moving. Closing the eyes. Bringing your attention to the space between the eyebrows. Connecting to something that's much greater than all of us. Into cloud pose, dropping the toes down towards the earth. And if you're in waterfall, allowing the knees to come into the chest, tucking them in. If the toes easily reach the earth, and dropping the knees by the ears. Thank you. Bending the knees and walking the feet in as close as you can. Setting up for bridge pose. So reaching with the fingertips towards the heels. On an inhale, we'll lift. Inhale and lift. Working the arms underneath the body. Once again, trying to bring the chest towards the chin. Walking the feet back, and do two more back bends. You can take bridge pose, or if you have wheel in your practice. So if you're going to take bridge, try to reach the fingertips towards the heels to begin. On an inhale, we'll lift. Inhale and lift the hips up. Working the chest towards the chin. Thank you. elbows last to come down. Once again, allow the knees to touch, walking the feet out towards the edge of the mat. And one final back bend, either bridge or wheel, so walking the feet back in. You're taking bridge on an inhale, we're going to lift the hips up, inhale and lift. You're taking wheel, placing the arm, the hands by the ears, pushing the body all the way up. Always breathe. Slowly bringing the body down. This time bringing the knees into the chest, tucking them in. Maybe rocking from side to side to massage the lower back. Finding stillness. Bringing the hands to the back part of the thigh, rolling the body up, coming into boat pose. So in boat pose, we can have our knees bent, extending the arms out, and straighten the legs. Make sure the spine is nice and tall, and chest is lifted. Dropping the legs down, leading with the heart, coming forward into Paschimottanasana, forward fold. Allow the heart to lead. Relax in the head and neck. Trying to get the body down onto the thighs. You have to bend your knees, bend your knees. Bringing the body back into table pose. Lifting the body up, opening up the chest. And then dropping the hips down. Bringing the legs behind, setting up for hare or rabbit pose. If you have shirshasana headstand in your practice, you can come into headstand. So for hare pose, we're going to sit on the heels, reach around for the heels. Trying to bring the forehead as close as we can to the knees and the crown of the head down to the earth, lifting the hips up. Bringing the body back down, resting in child's pose with the arms alongside the body. Return to your intention. and bringing the legs out in front again. Bring the left heel out to the corner of the mat, bending the right leg up, and bring that sole of the foot to the inner thigh, dropping the knee down to the earth. Sitting up nice and tall first, crown of the head is lifted, squaring the body towards that foot. Sweeping the arms up, knees up, and inhale. And leading with the heart, folding forward. Once again, trying to get the belly onto the thigh, relaxing the head and the neck. Allowing the body to float up one breath at a time. Switching feet, bringing the right foot out to the corner of the mat, left sole of the foot to the inner thigh, dropping the knee down. Sitting up nice and tall first, crown is lifted, squaring the body off towards that foot, sweeping the arms up, gaze up and inhale, and leading with the heart, folding the body forward. Coming all the way down onto the back, both legs extended out. Bringing the left knee into the body, hugging the hip. Bringing the right knee into the body, hugging the hip. Extending both legs long again. Coming into a final twist, so bringing that left knee into the body. Grabbing the knee with the right hand, bringing it across the body, extending the left arm out, gazing towards the left. Extending the leg out in front, bringing the other knee into the body, passing it off into the other hand, preparing the body for Shavasana. So allow the legs to be wider than the arm and the feet. Just lay down to the side. Arms are alongside the body, palms are face up. Take a breath in through the nose and exhale out of the mouth. Again, inhale through the nose and exhale out of the mouth. Allow the body to settle. concerns go. Returning back into the body. Finding a little movement in the fingers and the toes. And then taking the arms over fingertips all the way down the toes. And then rolling over onto your side, using your arm as a pillow. Always showing yourself gratitude. Gratitude for all you do for others. Gratitude for taking the time to connect with the breath, to move the body, and quiet the mind. And bringing the body up to a comfortable seat, keeping the eyes closed. Once again, feeling the sits bones grounded into the earth. The spine is tall and long. Shoulders are rolling down the back and the crown the head is lifted. Bringing your hands to heart center. Remembering the intention you set, carrying it with you for the rest of the day and all the days that follow. Take a nice deep inhale for the sacred sound of home. Inhale. Sees the divine light in you, and we are one. Namaste.